I'm a police officer. Are you okay? You can come out, sir. I'll escort you to the exit.
No, 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 no. I can't get out. My flashlight. It's out of batteries. I need batteries.
All right. I'll be right back. Don't move. Something told me that wasn't the best idea. Sensor detected me.
No, wait.
Right. Good. Mm-mm. something on that table.
Batteries for you, sir.
Oh, thanks. Oh, it's so dark in here.
Thank you.
Just a little redecorating. Hopefully I got the dam.
says, Professor Husher, remember to pick up your typewriter and the rest of your belongings from the library desk. This is the university library. If you need your own space, you can use your office. If Husher left documents in there, it may be worth taking a peek, too.
This might have something to do with Husher's investigation.
Let me see. God, did you read that? Argos Legrand, heir to the Legrand family and owner of the LGA Incorporated business conglomerate, has died under mysterious circumstances along with his wife and 8-year-old daughter. It occurred last night at the family's holiday home, where they were spending part of the spring after the famous magnate's most recent trip. While police remain open-minded in their official statements and maintain that all lines of inquiry remain open, popular theories suggest that the family fell victim to a violent robbery, leaving the younger daughter, Ariadne, the sole survivor. She is currently safe in police custody. Oh my God, they're all dead. This is a dead end. Husher left some documents at the library. Maybe there's something there. It's all that's left to check.
It's too quiet, even for a library. Shit! Where did that thing come from? stronger. Gotta be careful. Oh my god. Okay, I can't let it get me again. One less thing to do. Now I have to check the monitors again.
That has to be Sebastian's desk. I'm close. Sinister nature. Interesting. Damn it!
There was another book about Argos LeGrand in the library. A compilation of research trips written by two of his associates in the early 1900s. Sinister Nature was a kind of narration of LeGrand's frustrated trips in search of paranormal phenomena, with one of the last pages marked by Husha, the cursed consort, St. Cecilia's Abbey. St. Cecilia, the patron saint of music. I'm not sure what Husha wanted when he set out in LeGrand's footsteps, or how long he planned on doing it. But it was a start. The best place to start looking. Before it gets too late.
Isaac, my dear friend, you don't know what you've done with that cursed music box. By the time you tried to warn me, we had all heard the music. Now I find myself trapped in a tragic race against time. I had a hunch. I thought that perhaps by returning the box to you... Damn it, I've been such a fool. I lied, Isaac. I'm sorry. I just need you to hold on while I find a way to make things right. I left the house without telling Catherine. How could I possibly explain something like this? I thought she'd never believe me, and I was wrong. But now it's too late. I only hope you're all safe, and that you will find a way to forgive me. I must put an end to this once and for all. For my family, for you, and for my own sake. Argos LeGrant. Everything revolves around that name. He was the person who had the box crafted and picked out the melody. I know he died in 1913. Newspapers of the day reported a violent burglary in his home. Everyone died, save for Ariadne, who was just a baby at the time. The case was closed, but something just doesn't add up. The police investigation was far too short-lived, and the bodies were not buried, but incinerated. I believe they were trying to hide the truth. I discovered that the book, Natura Tenebrosa, was written by two of LeGrant's collaborators. The same two who followed him across Europe, researching all matter of ridiculous legends, all equally far-fetched. The last case in the book speaks of LeGrant's last journey, on which he embarked just before making the music box. I've followed in his footsteps for weeks now, visiting every place, following every lead about that melody. Alas, I have reached the last leg of this journey, in the north. I find myself among the deserted ruins of St. Cecilia's Abbey, now covered in snow. Here, in 1912, the annual concert in honor of the patron saint of music was held. LeGrant was not there at the time, but he came to investigate soon after. Every single person who attended that concert died or disappeared in mysterious circumstances, and the Abbey has been abandoned ever since. The connection is clear. I know there must be something here, a clue I can pursue. If not, I don't dare think about the future. I can barely distinguish what's real from what's not. Something is watching me, following me, drawing closer and closer by the day. The melody still haunts me. Its notes echo constantly in my head. With each passing minute, they sound more ghastly and foreign. I see darkness all around me, and shadows lurking in the corners. I see my world merging with something else. I see another place. The black figure. I feel it's here with me.
Time to move. I have to find it. Thank you. What's this?
If this works, let's see how much I have left.